All right, John Burke with A Better View, and this is the YouTube, more in-depth, definitely more rambling, and more serious, so I put on the headphones version. So what does it mean? What does it mean right now that the new construction price on the beach block of Sea Isle going into the spring of 2019 is going to be, I think, solidly around that $1.5 million number, a little bit off from there. Anything that exceeds expectation is really an A-plus home in the category, oversized. Really top of the line beach block location might be able to exceed that number, but nothing like that is showing up right now. As a matter of fact, the properties that are left, 3475th Street is pretty typical, good location, good location, not like 1479th Street, which we saw back in the spring, but a very good location. 5705 Pleasure, I think, is actually a great location. It's got some things going for it, but it's a little bit smaller than most other blocks. So, you know, with those priced, I think, well in the market right now at 1.5 million, probably going to get that. I think it's an indication that the typical standard good block, you know, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, if you're on some other blocks, it might be a little different. But the good block, beach block, new construction home is going to be at least 1.5 right now, or right around 1.5 right now. What does that mean? It means a bunch of things. I think the first thing that it means is we're starting to get a really dramatic gap again, which is similar to how things were before my career began. When I first entered this market, I started selling real estate 2011, 2012. We were really at the bottom of everything that had played out from 2008. And the whole market had gotten very, very, very compressed. What I mean is the difference in price from the beachfront back to, say, the 100 block or the 200 block in Sea Isle was much closer to each other than they'd been in a really long time. And we've slowly moved out from there. And we reached the point now where we see as much of a spread as we probably did at that point. There is still, I think, an opportunity on the beachfront. I think that's the last one to really establish some distance. That's going to happen very quickly in front of us right now. A lot of things played out in the course of the last year, and right in front of us, very quickly, there are some properties that have been sold that were never on the open market. When these prices show up, what people paid for some new construction and some other things up on the beachfront, you're going to see that the beachfront prices is sort of in a new spot too. So we are spread again. If there's something out there on the beachfront, it might be a good time to grab it. Additionally, a few investors, people who were buying properties strictly for investments or where it was a major part of their concern when they were buying it, more than just, you know, a vacation home, that I worked with, did buy beach block houses, older beach block houses, a few years ago. And the plan that we saw with those was they were having trouble selling versus a lot of brand new construction inventory on the 100 block. And because of that, their price was, you know, coming in lower than those 100 block houses. So people were picking up beach block houses, older beach block houses in the sevens going into the eights. And what we anticipated was when we got this spread again, when your next door neighbor is selling for $1.4, $1.5 million. Now, yes, it's a much newer house, but if you have a lot of the same features, a lot of the same size, and you go in and you renovate towards that, you know, putting $75,000, maybe $100,000 in, really decking it out, that you're going to be able to catch a lot of that. So you're going to have an opportunity to really have a home where some equity shows up out of nowhere. So hopefully, you know, those houses also too, they carry themselves so well on the beach blocks, they rent so well. The plan was to get to this point, and hopefully we're going to be seeing that going on right now. So there's probably an opportunity still. It's not as good as it was a few years ago, but with this new price showing up, this really high price showing up in the new ones, I still think the new ones are a great deal, don't get me wrong, because there's just not going to be many beach block new constructions ever built after this in Seattle. We're running out of space, at least not for a long, long time. So they're probably still a good opportunity. However, I still think there's a great opportunity if you can find a diamond in the rough, old one that you're willing to do some work in. Because now that we are increasingly a very, very premier community, prices, you know, average home price sale in Seattle is now $700,000 or so. You're finding the number of buyers that show up that are willing to do anything at all are few and far between. So if you are the sort of buyer who's comfortable taking on a project, I don't have a lot of buyers to come down and actually, you know, swing a hammer themselves. But if you're comfortable taking on a project and, you know, setting people up to get things done for you, there is an opportunity there. And the other big implication, see, this is a longer YouTube rambling version, but the other big implication with that spread is It does begin to create some room back on the 100 block for prices maybe to move up a little bit. We've already seen that obviously with the new construction. The new construction price on the 100 block is around $1 million right now, it appears. And when you start looking at the gap that's shown up again, there's probably even more room on the fill in there because there's not a lot. There's more, but there's not a lot of developable space left on the 100 block either. So those are definitely an opportunity. So that's, you know, what that means right now with the new construction price on the beach block at $1.5 million. I think that is a safe number going into spring. I think the ones that are out there right now, somebody came to me and said, is it worth it? I would say, yeah, you could go and buy it. Somebody else will buy it at that price. I don't think it's overpriced what they're asking, you know, somewhere between that 1.45 and 1.5, depending upon two. What you deck the house out with new construction if you get in early. So that's a bit on a few different things. If there is any follow-up, anybody's interested, if this has got you thinking anything, if you're wondering what your home is worth, if you own a home, you're considering moving, you're wondering what you're worth, obviously things have changed a lot in the last, you know, 2 years. So if you haven't talked to somebody, we would certainly love to talk to you at Burke & Company. There's a lot of us now. We got a really good team put together. We just added Dave Sedlick. Very exciting. He knows a lot of people in town. He's been doing this for a long time. We already had Chris McGurk, who's much in the same category. He's been doing this here for quite a while and has a lot of strong relationships. We've got Justine Harkins, who's sort of a silent member, who's going to show up with something huge at some point soon. But we have a lot going on. So if you're thinking about buying, selling, Seattle, really across the New Jersey Shore, but in particular in Seattle, we'd be happy to talk to you. So once again, I'm John Burke of Burke & Company. This is the longer, in-depth nerd version of A Better View that I stopped doing on Facebook. And it's only for those who are truly dedicated or truly bored or want some information. And you'll find it on YouTube. So with that, that's going to conclude this. And as always, you can reach us. Office team line is 609 478-0333. You can email the team at burkeandco@outlook.com. And of course, I'm at john.realestate@outlook.com. So once again, this has been A Better View. Thanks.